that people either want to kiss us or kill us for writing. So you know what it is, right? You're out of your way. Actually, it came about in such a very interesting way. Walt and the Imagineers at the studio were creating this wonderful, wonderful experience. It was going to be a salute to the children of the world. And it was originally called UNICEF Salutes the Children of the World. And we were asked to come down to a soundstage where there was a mock-up of what this was going to be. For no reason, Walt never said, you know, the reason I want you to come is for this. He just said, come down the stage after lunch on Thursday. So we came down to the steps at stage two, and there was this huge mock-up, and we saw, there was no lighting on it, but we just saw these various dolls. They looked beautiful. And he said, okay, crank it up, start it up. So they started it up, and all of a sudden we heard music coming from these various groups of dolls. And each one of the dolls was singing a national anthem of the various countries that these beautiful little dressed dolls were singing. And for about 15 feet or so, it was kind of exciting because you heard, all of a sudden you heard nothing. You heard just a jumble of stuff. It was a big hogwash. It was one of those ideas that on paper read beautifully, but in point of fact, in actuality, it was a disaster. So Walt said, okay, kill it, kill it. I remember saying he killed the sound, and I remember the little Dutch doll was clicking his little feet together at the time. So he'd click, click, and ratchet, ratchet, and nothing else. And he said, you guys are going to write me a song that's going to explain this whole thing. So what do you mean, Walt? He said, well, this is not going to work. You can see that. So he says, well, we want you to write a simple little song, a little roundelay. So, see, you know, I thought he meant, you know, around, you know, row your boat for 10 minutes and we drive it out of your mind. So I thought fast, I said, Walt, how about a counterpoint, or two little tunes that can work together and contrapuntal? He said, that's what I said, a roundelay. Well, to make a long story short, we wrote a simple little song. And as Richard Allen said, and he gave me credit for it, no, it was my father who said, keep it simple, singable, and sincere. And that was what it was all about. We wrote a simple, singable, sincere song. And I'm going to play it for you the way we first wrote it, because really it truly is a prayer for understanding and peace. The young people in the world are the hope of the future, and that's what it was all about. So I'm going to play it for you the way we wrote it, because we wrote it slowly. It wasn't this well-known jingle that everybody hears today. But I'm going to play it that way, and if you remember the lyric, when you get to the chorus, maybe you'll help me with it, okay? It's a world of laughter, a world of fears. It's a world of hopes and a world of fears. There's so much that we share that it's time we're aware. It's a small world. After all, there is just one moon and one golden sun, and a smile means friendship to everyone. Though the mountains divide and the oceans are wide, it's a small world after all. 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 It's a small
thank you.